The video is Lila Nishmas with Shmuel Baruch and Chaim Tzvida. We're starting the week of Yesod. Yesod that Zohar Kodesh says is Emunah. How to develop Emunah. And we're starting with the Chesed should be Yesod. I want to share, first of all, with the Olam, an answer to the question that we left off on Friday. So I got some beautiful responses. So I'll tell you the answer that for years I was walking around with. And but because my son, Yaakov Yosef, I told this over, he wasn't happy. So we had to come up with a new pshat. So we left off with a question. We said, why is it that when it comes to the parsha of Shemitah, it says that the food is going to be given to the human beings before the animals? And when it comes to the parsha of Hayom Shemoya, we learn, no, v'nosati metal artzichem be'ito yoreu malkoish v'safta degonecha v'siru ischa v'yitzarecha. And then, which means that the pasuk says clearly, first the animal should have food, and then you. And we learn from that an incredible halacha that you can't eat yourself, sit down to a meal before you feed your animal. And we had a question: does that apply to every animal? Is a person not allowed to eat breakfast until he feeds the fish, and all the different cute animals that we had, many people have today? So, I'll tell you what the Tvuah show, an incredible chiddush. That the sefer says, I think the sefer was called Tvuah Shoh, and it said like this: the whole idea behind why a person can't sit down and eat before feeding the animal is Akoras HaTov. Who do we have? Which animal? Especially in the old days. Today we have a hard time appreciating this, but those that have a farm, had a farm, those that had animals working in the field, one of the most important animals was the shoh. The pasuk says in Mishlei, Roiv Tvuois Bekoach Shoh. Most of the grain that people had in those days was because of the shoh of the ox being able to pull and to thresh. So therefore there's an expression of a kol satov, we have to show gratitude. So therefore Hashem said, you want to, before you eat, make sure you have gratitude. Where do you think you got this bread from? So therefore, the halacha is you have to give the animal the shoh first. However, Shemitah year, it says that no one was working in the field. The animal wasn't working in the field. So therefore there was no chiv of a kol satov. So there's no obligation of showing gratitude. So therefore, there's no obligation to give in the seventh year the animal first. You could eat first. This is such a profound and an amazing answer. The reason why it's, besides it being so insightful, it's halachically changing. Why? Because that would mean that any animal that's not really working for you, so there's no obligation to show a kol satov. And there are poskim that hold that. Therefore, those that own, whether it's mice, whether it's weasels, whether it's snakes, whether it's whatever a person owns, fish. They're not working for us. One might argue that maybe the entertainment and people have cats in order to lower the blood pressure and a different reason, so maybe there is a kol satov. But on the surface, it would take away the obligation. Very interesting chiddush. However, my son wasn't happy with this. He said, so because this year the animal's not working, I'm not going to show a kol satov. I'm not going to express the fact that Hashem gave me an animal that provides for 6 years. I thought that was a very good question. And we'll leave off the Olam. The Olam could come up with another answer. But what I think I want to take from this chesed, for our avodah this week of chesed, should be yesod. And the whole week of yesod, which is really getting ready for Matan Torah, is appreciation. Tzidkus, the Zohar says, is emunah, is to develop our emunah. How do we develop our emunah? How do we make it more real? That's something that we need to hopefully develop and internalize this week. Hopefully, b'siyata d'shmaya, we should be zeiche. In the meantime, have an amazing week and appreciate, enjoy the beautiful weather. Have in mind all the people that are homeless. Daven for them, especially in Eretz Yisrael, those that went through the different fires. It's taka scary to see the statements of Chazal and Reb Chaim Kanievsky's warning before. And Bli Nedel discuss that really attaches to tomorrow's sefiras. But Hashem should be merachem and klali so that we should be zeicher for the gula b'mehera b'yameinu. And the only fire that we should see, the Chazal say it's based on the pasuk that Hashem is going to put a fire around Yerushalayim, around the Beis HaMikdash. It says that Beis HaMikdash is going to come down with a Beis HaMikdash of fire. B'mehera b'yameinu. Hatzlacha.